seawall footer. Property length is 60 linear feet, and the dock is about 8 years old, maybe 10 years old. The lumber is in fair condition, not more than that. Probably will need to be replaced in a few years. From looking from the top side, I don't see any indication of undermining the property. We did some probing the ground here. The ground seems to be dense. I don't see any indication of large sinkholes or any kind of strong erosion happening along the property line. The cap is underneath the dock right now, so we can't see it. This is the south corner. Has some areas where it's bowing, but that's not unusual. We're going to look at the supports on the underside. We'll start the inspection from the north side, working our way to the south. This inspection is conducted by Simi Dive on the 26th of January, 2016, in beautiful Miami, Florida. Into the water. Property is on the north to south axis. It appears like there is a concrete base. It is the 4x4s. They're not in the greatest condition, but somebody did go ahead and put some tar epoxy on the bracket. Good thing. I'm going to walk along here. There's another hairline crack on the cap. The neighboring property, and they have some issues here, and that could affect the property. There's also a small separation right here between the cap and the concrete slab that was poured here for the fence. Laid on. Sheet piling. Sheet piling seems to be in okay condition. The lumber on the dock here is probably on its way out. This side, the lumber is lying right against the seawall. You can see the base here of the davit. little chipped in the corners, but that's got nothing to do with structural integrity. It looks good. Check the footer again. Okay, we've reached the south side. Dove along the entire length of the bottom footer. It's in relatively good condition. No signs of penetration. Expecting the south section of the south part of the seawall, south quadrant, so the first savage shows that this area has some cracks in it. There's a separation right here along, and it's right through the cap. That should be addressed. Also here, this is, see, this is, I'm not going to try and break it, but this seems hollow, and there's a hole over here. So probably a recoating of this area would be advised. And it's the only real dominating crack. Whole area of cracks is about 6 feet. Could be reinforced with some rebar to allow it to mine again. And the footer itself, the concrete footer, is in good shape. There's no indication of any hydrostatic loading that caused any problems with it. Again, this is the south side, looking at the framework of the dock. Fair, no more than fair. Somebody also used galvanized brackets on this cross support, and that's not advisable. Also, the hardware used here, the entire structure of the dock and the decking is mild steel galvanized, and it's no longer either or. Concrete anchors by various degree of corrosion, and the dock is will need to be replaced, as I said earlier, in the next few years. Fuel itself, the midsection is appears to be like they poured concrete here over the rock. Hairline crack on the south base of the davit. That's a pretty long crack. It goes all the way, and there is some folding over here and some rust penetration. The rebar is corroding underneath the concrete, and it's coming out. This should be repaired again. This is some longitudinal hairline crack here, here, and it's not unusual for the age of the seawall. The good seawalls, you know, dive.